Hello, and welcome to another episode of 5 Minutes with Franza. This episode is going to be about the five basic types of portable computers that you have to choose from, just to make sure you have the right terminology and you understand what it is that you're looking at if you're going to go and get yourself a portable PC. We're going to start off with the smallest and lightest, and this is called a Slate PC. Your iPad, which is what this is a perfect example of a Slate PC. No keyboard, no mouse, no DVD player. It is a touch screen, and you interact with it. The way that it gets out to the rest of the world is through the internet. So you need to have Wi-Fi in your house, wherever it is that you're going to be using this, or you're really not going to feel like you're getting the same bang for your buck. But a great little device. You do pay a premium, because after all, it's relatively new, and you're getting a lot of technology packed into a small area. So if you want to surf the web, use your iTunes, you know, watch a movie on Netflix or something like that, this is a great little device for that. You can even do some basic word processing, but I would not do any real video editing or playing serious games on this. This device isn't going to do that. Also be careful, some Slate PCs use non-standard operating systems. An example would be the iPad right now is using the same operating system, or it's a similar operating system to what the iPhone and iPod Touch use, not Mac OS. So you're gonna not have the same functionality on this that you would on a desktop PC or a laptop. But great, cool. Next up, and actually relatively cheap, is what's called a netbook. Netbooks have roughly a 10.1 inch screen across. I have seen some as large as 12. But your largest netbook is going to be the same size as your smallest laptop. Netbooks are great. They have usually have additional ports on them, like USB, a video port, a VGA port. While you could play games on it, it's probably got about the same crunch power, maybe a little bit more than your Slate PC. But great, ultra portable. They usually have a webcam built into them, so you can Skype, surf the web, do word processing. This is my daughter's and she loves it. Very affordable. Next we have your basic laptop. Laptops have anywhere from a 12.1 inch screen to less than 17 inches, which is about 15.6. Usually they will have a DVD drive built into them, something that the other ones don't have. Of course it's slightly larger. Because it's larger, it does have more horsepower under it. You could do some video editing, especially on a higher end laptop. Play decent games on it, but you will sacrifice battery life. This guy gets about 8 hours worth of battery life, give or take. This one is 4 to 5 hours, give or take. This one, 4 hours on a given day if I'm lucky and I don't use too much stuff. But this has a larger hard drive on it, more RAM, it's got more power. So that's always the trade-off, power versus battery life. A slight derivation of a laptop is something that we call a tablet PC. If a Slate and a laptop had a baby, this would be it. It's kind of cool. You can do something like this. This is a touch-sensitive screen. It has a stylus so that I can use and I can mark it up. I can write on this one. It is great. I like this a lot. This costs a little bit more than a laptop because, of course, you have this extra piece, the tablet functionality. But it has about the same crunching power as a standard laptop. Screen size is roughly 12.1 inches. There's also something called a desktop replacement. A desktop replacement is like a laptop, but on steroids. It's got a 17-inch or larger screen. It has the most crunch power that you're gonna get. It's gonna be on par with your desktop PCs. A lot of bang for the buck, but portable, it's the heaviest thing out there. And the battery life is the shortest. But if you predominantly use a regular PC and you only use it as a laptop or as a portable device, few and far between, it might be a way that you want to go, especially if you're a heavy gamer and you do video editing. Some other quick notes about portable devices. Think about printing. If you have a printer, it probably needs to connect via USB. If you don't have a printer, get one that has networking built into it, a Wi-Fi built in. Portable devices, you don't want to have to connect. Battery life, always remember, check on that. What operating system does the machine use, because then you know what type of software you can and cannot use on it. And quickly before we go, docking stations. A docking station, and not all laptops have docking stations, so you're going to have to ask either the person in the store or the manufacturer just on their website. But a docking station allows me to have power, keyboard, mouse, video, all connected into it, and I leave this here. And now, like this, I use my full keyboard, I use my full mouse, I use my screen, all is good, and then when I'm done, I take this with me. It's almost the best of both worlds. I hope you found this episode of 5 Minutes with Franza useful. Thank you. I'm your host, Dr. Thomas Franza.